Hey guys, welcome to Code Revolution. This is Paul. I want to give you a quick, short summary of what we do with the Code Revolution. It's different. The main thing here is we actually install and configure a Minecraft server. That gives us a lot more options to learn about computers. It's not just a little programming. It's also, in this case, starting out with a brand new build. We are installing Java, the actual Java runtime, which gives us a chance to talk to the students about what that means. We also install the Java development kit, which is what we're doing here. The development kit opens up a lot of doors to the different programming environments. All of this is done with the Minecraft Java PC edition. We don't do this with Bedrock or console editions, which is mobile. If you already have Minecraft for PC, you can skip this. But the great part about this is you can play Minecraft on your computer and program. One of the big things here that we don't really get to see much is Git, which is what we just installed. Git is one of the most popular source control. It's probably the most popular source control, which is a code control. It's used all over the place these days, professionally as well. We also, in order to program, we have to do things like Thani and Eclipse. Thani is a Python environment. Eclipse is a Java environment. We start out using Python to learn programming, and then we jump into Java right away, basically to build server plugins. So the good part about setting up our server, which is what we're doing right here, we're running the server for the first time. We're figuring out how to write a simple startup script that allows us to start and configure some basic memory options on our server, which is running on our Windows computer. It just showed us that we had a little Windows firewall right there, so that's great. We learned a little bit about that. And then right now we're actually doing some programming. On the left, I've got a Thani window with a bunch of Python code, functions, loops, if statements, all kinds of good stuff. And I've basically hidden a gold block in my Minecraft world, and I'm using my Python to try to find it. I'm also doing some things to help myself out right here. That is, I'm printing my depth out to the chat window in Python so that I know exactly how deep I am, because I know I've used the Python to scan and find the block. I just don't know exactly how deep I am as I'm digging. So I'm kind of cheating a little bit, but that's the fun thing about Python. And there we go. Thanks for joining. Hope you appreciate it, and please be sure to follow me and like me on my YouTube channel.